Now we're just going to practice a little bit with non-homogeneous second-order ODEs, constant coefficients, just doing the practice. You're going to find the homogeneous solution, you're going to find the particular solution, then you're going to apply the initial conditions, and that's really all there is. So if I were you, I would pause the video and go ahead and get started. Look at old notes, look at other things that you've done, see how far you can get on these, because if you just watch me do them, then once I've done them, then you can't, like, do it fresh, I guess. So you want to pause the video, go see how far you can get. You can always come back and check, do the little checkpoints along the way and see if you're doing well. But my recommendation, pause the video, see how far along you can get. So let's assume you've done that. Yay! All right. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to solve the homogeneous. Solve the homogeneous version. So this is like step one. Let me get rid of this one because it's confusing. No, I don't know. This really doesn't matter. How about step one? See, this is why it's hard to get things accomplished, because you can't stop messing with the outline. Step one. Okay, solve the homogeneous version. So I've got y homogeneous prime prime. This is just not pretty. Minus 2y homogeneous prime plus y homogeneous is equal to 0. Now, I see I have my little constant coefficient thing, 2r plus 1 equals 0, r minus 1 squared. So I have r equals 1 with a multiplicity of 2. So that means my homogeneous solution is in the form c1 e to the positive x and c2 x e to the positive x. Next step is to find a particular solution, which means I have to find any solution that will match. Now, because I'm super amazing, I'm going to guess that something is in the form ax squared plus bx plus c, because that matches the format of that here, and that's just generally a good guess. And if it's you didn't see the video on the theory behind this and it looks like we're doing crazy stuff, you should go watch the video. If not, just play along. So if you are kind of making some progress and kind of got stuck and you know what you're doing now, pause the video and go see if you can get it all done on your own now. All right, so I'm going to put in the y double prime. So I've got 2a minus 2y prime. What's that one? 2y prime, which is 2ax plus b. And then I've got plus y, which is all of that, ax squared plus bx plus c, and that has to equal x squared minus x minus 3. So I'm going to go ahead and do all this. Now, this is where it's really important not to lose track of what you're doing. I like to count all my terms just to make sure I still have them every time I do this. So I'll call that minus 4ax minus 2b. This is where algebra is going to kill you. I got nothing to say except this is where algebra is going to kill you. So I've got minus 4a is a coefficient of x and b is a coefficient of x. I also like to mark them. So like I used that one and I used this one and I used this one. Okay, so that means that everything else, so that's going to be 2a minus 2b plus c. So that was 1, 2, and this one. So I had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 terms there. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 terms there. So that's good. You really, really, really want to be careful. You miss one thing and the whole thing's over. It's very unfortunate. So based on matching coefficients, a has to be 1, minus 4a plus b has to be negative 1, and 2a minus 2b plus c has to be negative 3. So minus 4 plus b is negative 1, plus 4 on both sides, b is 3, yes, and 2 minus 6 plus c minus 3 minus 4 plus c is minus 3 plus 4 to both sides. C is 1. All right, so that means that my particular solution is in the form a 1x squared plus bx plus c. So I can combine the two of those and I can make my full solution, which is that I'm proposing x squared plus 3x plus 1 plus c1 e to the x plus c2 e to the c2x e to the x. Beautiful. Now, I need to apply my, whatever you call it, I need to apply my initial conditions. This is step 3. And I'll write them again. My initial conditions were that y at 0 was equal to negative 2, and y prime at 0 is equal to 1. So again, if you got kind of close, and then you got just kind of messed up a little bit, pause the video, see how far you can get again the second time. It really doesn't hurt to get some exposure and get some practice doing this. It's really boring looking, but that's okay. So y at 0, that's negative 2, 0, 0, 1, c1, c2. Y prime at 0 is 0, 3, c1, c2, and 0. Oh, this one's 0, too, because it applies to 0. So I think b minus 1 from both sides. So c is negative, c1 is negative 3. So I've got 2, or 1 is equal to 3 plus negative 3 plus, yeah, so c2 is just 1. And finally, I can pull my full solution, which is that y is equal to x squared plus 3x plus 1 plus c1, which is minus 3 e to the x, and then plus c2, which is 1x e to the x. And I've got a lovely, beautiful, full solution to my constant coefficient, linear, second order, ordinary differential equation. Fantastic. All right, so we'll look at this one. Now, again, if you haven't already solved this, but you just watched the previous video, pause it and try to work this one out, because you like maybe have a little bit more confidence until you get to the initial condition part, and that's fine. All right, so just see what you can do. Remember, the first step is always to solve the homogeneous. So we have y double prime homogeneous plus 8y prime homogeneous plus 7y homogeneous is equal to 0. And I see the constant coefficients and I write my characteristic equation. R minus plus 1, r plus 7, r is equal to negative 1 or negative 7. So I have a homogeneous solution, c1 e to the minus x plus c2 e to the minus 7x. Okay. Oh, this looks like work. Okay. Step 2. So sad. Find particular solution. And I'm going to equate coefficients again, except now it's going to be really annoying because I have 4. I'm going to have x cubed, bx squared, cx, d prime. Double prime. And plug in stuff. 6ax plus 2b plus 8 times this thing, 3ax squared plus 2bx plus c plus 7y. You've got to love algebra to do Diffie Q. I think that's part of it. That's why I always like Diffie Q, is because I love algebra, because it's math. I like all math, except for statistics, because that's not really math. Minus x plus... I'm sure some people think it's math. I think I don't like it because I wasn't good at it. Which is why I love Diffie Q, because it's kind of fun. All right. I'm going to write this out. 24ax squared, 16bx, 8c, and 7ax cubed, 7bx squared, 7cx d7, or 7d, 7d, and that's going to equal all this stuff with the 6ax. That's supposed to be a 6. You can't tell that it's a 6, but it is 6ax plus 2b plus all that. Okay, that was super fun. You can't even see everything on the page. It was so fun. All right. So then I'm going to combine like terms. So anything with a square. So there is a squared. Oh, wait, no, I have to start with cubes. There should be one cubey thingy. All right, so that's 7ax cubed. And then the coefficients for x squared are 24a and 7b. 24a, 7b. And then the coefficients for x are 6a, 16b, 7c. Like that. And I think like that. And then the constants are 2b, 8c, and 7d. 8c and 7d. Oh, there's an x there. Plus. There we go. Okay, now, if that wasn't amazing, I don't know what could be. It equals all of that. So, this is all just to find part of the problem. 7a is equal to 7, so a is equal to 1, that's nice. 24a, which is 1, plus 7b is equal to 24. So, b is equal to 0. 6 times 1 plus 16 times 0 plus 7c is equal to negative 1. Subtract 6 from both sides. Oh, look how pretty these are. All right, the last one is 2 times 0 plus 8 times c, which is negative 1, plus 7 times d is equal to negative 8. That means 7d is 0, d is 0. Now I can finally write my particular solution, which is ax cubed plus bx, which is 0, minus plus cx plus 0. So there's my particular solution, and I can come up now, combine that with my homogeneous to get a full solution of x cubed minus x plus c1e to the minus x plus c2e to the minus 7x. And all would be perfectly fine, except that I have these goofy initial conditions that are not centered at 0. Now, if you remember, we had a bit of a trick for that. So those are my initial conditions. And we had a bit of a trick for it. Now, the trick was recognizing that in the homogeneous portion of our problem, that I could actually rewrite the coefficients without any trouble whatsoever. My puppies are making funny noises in the background. All right, so I could, and I'm just kind of go through this trick again just a little bit. I'm just going to randomly multiply this by e cubed. And you'll see why in a second if you don't already remember, because it's just a constant, so I can just multiply it by another constant and it still doesn't matter. Actually, I'm going to make this one here 21. The reason being that I could rewrite this as e to the minus x minus 3, and that would still, well, let me not take that extra step. Minus x plus 3 plus c2. And so these aren't really the same c1s. These could be some other c1s, so I could just call them a and b if it makes you feel better to not use the same c1s and c2s. So this would be, basically, I would say that some random constant c1 is some other random constant times e cubed, and that's okay. And in the future, you can skip all this gobbledygook and just go straight to the problem, or straight to where we're going. I just want to kind of do this to remind you of what's going on, because I only mentioned it once, and it was a while ago, and if, you know, assuming you're not watching these in order or anything like that. So b e to the minus 7 x minus 3. So really what I'm saying is you can go from here to here without any loss of generality. So this is still totally legit. This first line is totally legit. The second line is totally legit. The only reason I might prefer the second line is it makes it easier to apply my initial conditions, and it gets prettier constants for my initial conditions, I guess. I don't know. It just makes it a little bit easier to solve. So now I can take the, so this is step three. Apply initial conditions. So, 3x squared minus 1 plus, or minus, I guess, minus a e to the minus x minus 3, and then minus 7b e to the minus 7x minus 3, like that, because that's how, you know, differentiation works. Okay, so now I can apply y at 3, and the whole reason I did this is so if I apply y at 3, I have 6 is going to be equal to 3 cubed minus 3 plus a, and this is going to now be e to the 0, and that's just nice because it gets the e's out of my coefficients, and this is going to be again e to the 0, which is 1, like that. So I've got that, what is that, 27 minus 3 is equal to 6 plus a plus b. So I have no idea what that is. 24, subtract that from both sides, I get some other number like 18 or something. Minus 18 is equal to a plus b. So that's my regular one, and I'm going to apply my prime one. So I know y prime at 3 is equal to negative 2. So I've got negative 2 is equal to 3 negative 2 squared minus 1 minus a, and again, to the 0, or e to the 0, which is 1, minus 7b. So 3 times 4 is 12. And that's 11. If I subtract that from both sides, I get, oh, this is hard, minus 13. Was minus a minus 7b. Okay, so now I can do math and get this, and then I'll be all done and I'll be happy and I can move on with my day. And you can move on with your day, or you can do more math or whatever it is that makes you happy. Minus a minus 7b equals minus 13. Whooshoo! And minus 6b, I have no idea what that is. A 1, 31, these are not pretty. I clearly just made these up. Minus, but it's 31 over 6, and a plus 31 over 6 is equal to whatever 18 times 6 is, 48 and 108. Whatever that minus or plus 31, I'm probably doing something goofy here because I just made this up before I whatever's. So those aren't beautiful numbers, but you know what? There's a place in the world for ugly numbers too. So anyways, so I've got a full solution that y is equal to x cubed minus x. So if you think these are ugly, they would be even worse, because remember that we said that a was going to be equal to some, did I erase it? Yeah, a was going to be equal to some like e to the something or other times the other constant that we had. So these are actually a lot prettier than maybe they should be, or those pretties are going to get. Minus 139 over 6 e to the minus x minus 3, and b, which is 31 over 6, times e to the negative 7, x minus 3. And that would be a beautifully full solution, really fantastic. Remember, the strategy is you find the homogeneous solution, you find the particular solution, and then you apply your initial conditions and just do whatever you got to do to make it work. And that's that.